I knew it.
You got it?
Hey, we're MKTO.
Yeah, glad to be here.
Let's do it.
Artistry. What's up?
I'm calm.
Can you describe your band name?
Well, first it's our initials, Malcolm Kelly, Tony Aller, and then we have another cool meaning, which is Misfit Kids and Total Outcast. Kind of just about being yourself. I mean, when we were growing up, we were kind of, you know, not going with the norm, just doing our own thing. He's from Texas, you know, it's kind of big on sports and whatnot, but he was going for acting and, you know, pursuing music. And I was homeschooled during high school, you know, just following my own dream, which was acting. So we just kind of wanted to relate with people with, on that note, Misfit Kids and Total Outcast. So, yeah.
Well, let me just understand, you know, we get it. Like, I understand, especially with these times and days, there's a lot of stuff with hazing and a lot of people feeling they're getting bullied, and we want to understand to them, like, we get it, like, that's something we went through, you know. New shooting loss, he had plenty of hazing with just wanting to be an actor, look what happened. Same with me, with, like, wanting to do acting in Texas. If you weren't doing football, it wasn't a cool thing, so, you know, you were a weirdo. Well, guess what, being a weirdo can pay off, so.
And our first single was Thank You.
Here we are, first time in Hong Kong, thanks to doing music, yeah. So we're very grateful, and it just goes to show you that anything is possible.
That's right.
Can you describe what your sound is? Describe where you got it, because
what you need. Well, when we first started, we did we kind of started off B.O.B. and Hayley Williams Airplanes, like with the rapping and, you know, the singing melodies on the hook. So we kind of just let that kind of take the forefront of our album. We got the, you know, we blended that well together, and we're just finding our sound. I think we found it, you know, it's pretty good, yeah. Like with the singing and the rapping. So you get a lot of different sounds on this album, like ballads, club songs. We have one with Neo on there that's pretty cool. So it just tells a lot of stories on the album. So I think you guys really dig it.
So what's the songwriting process?
I mean, I don't know if there's a process.
It could be crazy.
It's one of those things where I think, as anybody that writes songs, it could be something that happens at 2 in the morning. It could be something that you just never know. So something that we're really, what we really enjoy is being able to take the studio everywhere we go. So regardless, if, you know, 3 a.m. we're still up in Hong Kong, we have an idea for a song, we can record it, lay it down, bring it to the studio. If it works out, then we'll go from there. But yeah, it's one of those things, we lay down a lot of concepts and just kind of, you know, see where it leads us. And if it's something we are sticking with after a week of listening to, then it's something we continue to go with. But we signed with awesome producers, Eman and Evan, that are awesome dudes, and have really helped us as writers kind of grow and learn a lot of things. So it's something we really enjoy and something we're really proud of. But we're growing each and every day, and it's just something we're really proud of. So, album coming soon.
Yes. Self-titled MKT. Oh.
Yes. Does MKTO ever get in the way of your friendship? Because you've been friends for a long time.
I think it actually brought us together.
Yeah.
We met on a show called Gigantic. We played Best Friends. We had a lot of downtime in between where we just kind of put up YouTube covers and just kind of have fun with it. Just see what happens. We'd see a lot of comments going, oh, what do you think about going on tour? What would that be like? We kind of were like, oh, well, that'd be surreal. That'd be awesome, you know, picture-perfect moment. But we weren't really sure that would happen. So when stuff kind of picked up, when we did this cover called Champion, it really got the look of the producers that we signed with and then led us to signing with our label. But yeah, it's one of those things that just kind of happened organically.
Yeah.
Do you see yourselves working together in 10 years' time?
Yeah, man.
Better be. I'll be happy.
Yeah.
I mean, this is my best friend. It's something I would never be able to do a band, like with, you know, six people or anything like that. And I respect anybody that can do that, but this has been a dude that's been my brother since day one, and it's just been fun for us. So when it's not fun, we're not going to do it anymore. But it's something that we have fun with, so we're going to keep doing it until we don't have fun anymore.
Longevity.
Yeah.
So what have been the highlights and low points of your career?
So far, I mean, it's been a crazy year. I mean, just to think that we got signed a year ago.
Yeah.
What about
Australia?
I was just about to get to that. I mean, Australia kind of took off for us. We have two platinum singles over there, working on our third, which is God Only Knows, which is doing really good. So it's just been crazy, man. We got plaques, and it's like we're in Hong Kong, you know, all throughout the first year. So it's just been so crazy, so surreal. So it's been great.
I think the only, I guess you would, I wouldn't really call it a down point, but I guess the one thing about doing what we do is that you travel a lot. So you don't really get to see a lot of friends or family that you normally see on a daily basis. But it's something that's a sacrifice in a sense that it's totally worth it. Like, yeah. You know, you get to go to these places like Hong Kong and get to perform for Hennessy Artistry and get to meet these people that are all sharing the common goal, which is just doing something they love. And I think that's something that's really important that a lot of people lost fact in. If you're hanging out with people that enjoy doing what you love doing, it's just an immediate bond. And it's something we really love to do.
Yeah.
Do you find that when you go home, you're kind of alienated from friends you thought were really close friends before?
Yeah, because then you realize
you'll find out. You'll find out who the real ones are, man.
Yeah.
They go away because you're away doing something, and they're probably not your real friends. But if they're there, you know, and they understand what you're doing, then that's pretty cool. So yeah, it's good to look forward to those friends, you know.
Agreed.
So, have you ever been involved in an event like this?
We haven't, but it was so cool. We got a phone call about it a while ago and just thought it was such a cool concept to really bring people together. And like we said at the end of the day, we want to meet people that enjoy doing what we do.
Get to collab with us.
You know, getting to work with the people we're going to get to work with and collab with. We're going to be doing a song with a girl who's an amazing singer, doing I Believe I Can Fly duet. But just getting to combine, you know, from different worlds and bringing together, which music is a common language.
Yeah.
It's something that's so cool because regardless of what you speak, music is the common language.
Yeah.
So it's something that's so beautiful. We thank Hennessy and Hennessy Artistry for having us. And
glad to be here, baby.
Yes, we're very excited. Can't we
can't
see
wait
you guys
to
at
perform.
The show.
Oh my gosh.
Very, very excited. It's going to be fun.
What do you think, what effect do you think it'll have on your career? Like, I mean, positive effect, I mean.
Just bringing new fans.
Yeah.
You know, and getting to perform in a place we never get to perform before, so. Yeah, man, it's just all pretty crazy. I mean, it's just the whole team is here, and we're just taking it in day by day. It's amazing.
We enjoy that. We enjoy being able to perform, regardless of anybody. I mean, you know,
has
I mean, honestly though, like that's not what it's about for us. Like,
right.
I think we're still the same, you know, dudes sitting in our apartment, going, "This would be cool to do this and perform this and that," but. It's one of those things that, like, we like that because we like earning people, you know, respect. And, like, if they enjoy our sound, then
being
great.
The underdogs,
but, like,
yeah,
we like that. We like that. So we just hope people enjoy the sound and, you know, possibly have the song stuck in their head the rest of the year.
Nothing comes easy. We're willing to work for it. So.
Yes. Teamwork.
Teamwork. So.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool.
Sweet. Oh.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Tony.
And I'm Malcolm. We are MKTO.
We are wishing you a happy holidays and a happy new year
holidays.
To Boom Magazine. Have a wonderful year. Thank you so much for
Thank
the
you
support.
Guys.
Thank you.